Hi. Oh, I'm here. I'm going to do a quick short stream today because I don't have much time for a lot, really. I really only have like an hour and a half, which is kind of sad. I was hoping to start myself about half an hour earlier, but I had to prepare for the thing I have to go to immediately after this, but I didn't want to, especially after not streaming last night, didn't want to just not play at all today. So yeah, I'm here. Hi. I'm gonna go to the video game. Wee. It's the game. Wow, it's my login screen. Can you believe it? I need to quickly just use that to go pause the music, the extra music in the background, because otherwise I will go insane from a layer of both Final Fantasy's audio added to some lo-fi. That would be funny, and I would die. But we're gonna, as you can see from the title, we're going to the place, going to cool Endwalker spoiler place that is super obvious because of the main menu, but hey, you know what they say. Spoilers, anyway, I guess, is what they say in this situation. It's fine. We're going. We're doing it. But I gotta be as my main class. Let's go. Main job. Whatever. That one. The Sea of the Stars. Time to spend 6 quintillion gil on a trip that is... I discovered after I ended stream last time that traveling here is not always cheaper than traveling to Shaolin. But it is most of the time, and that's what's funny to me. It's like, yes, I could go north for a lot of money, or up here for somehow less often. I've already made that joke, I know, but it's because it's still funny. It's still very funny to me. Let's go upstairs again. Up the tower, yay. Because I... You know, being down here and all that. I'm gonna check for meat repairs of anything. Surely not. Oh, right. Because I helped my friend Renaki run the last bits of Realm Reborn MSQ. We did the three things in the roulette. And I was playing as Astro, which was fun. But it is still level 81, so... Cannot do this level, I don't know actually. 83 MSQ. A couple levels. That's all it takes. Whee! It's still funny that since I can't fly, I just have a bird walking. Hi, friend! Let's see. My main would, I think, be these four, which is Warrior, Astro, Reaper, and Samurai. Haven't touched Samurai in a little bit, not since... mid-ish Shadowbringers, though I did put it up to 80 at least. Yeah, this is what my kind of stuff looks like. I've picked up every tank because I decided I wanted to do that for some reason, and I have played the intro quest to Sage. That was fun. Really enjoying Machinist. Hoping to do a bit more of that because it's real good. But yeah, this is my kind of main layout of Warrior being my absolute main. I'm really enjoying Dirk. I want to level that up a bit more. And Astro is just so much fun. Oh, it's so much fun. What about you? I'm actually curious now. Well, I will be surprised if Astro is not there somewhere now that I think about it. let's see. What have we got? You must confront those lost souls, yes, but you need not expel them by might of arms. I mean, I'm curious now. It's okay, I'm sorry, friend. Oh, it's alright. It's okay, I can Astro. What can I do? A feather touch, a firm word, simple methods may send them away, faint echoes as they are. Where the strength of sentiment that drives them, however, emotions that do not fade even with the passage of centuries. Mmm. Okay. A case, though distant, not yet distant, unwelcome guests draw closer. Ooh. Well, it's time to jump off a building, I guess, Lamel. Ah, I see. Near lethal damage, my favorite. Damoo! It's true. Basically, yeah, as I'm sure you're extremely aware, My man Xenos decided to make like Yami Yugi and attack the moon. Crazy, huh? Machinist rip. It's fine. It'll be great. It'll be. Look. What is it? 60? It's fine. It's not terrible. It's just I want to be better at it. What do you got here, friend? Where, when, how long? Okay. Wish it was good. I love the class. Is it just genuinely not at this point? It's a nice of a craft domain over everything. Ooh, okay. Also, it's top tier and ranked. As in, like, PvP? Or, like, do you mean, like, genuinely, like... Yeah. Huh. Now, that is interesting. I don't tend to touch PvP content. But, that is funny to know, I guess. Truly so long ago? Might be, I guess. Maybe there is a slight chance I'll join you if there's friends along for the ride, but... happy at peace with the star. Nurtured it, helps it grow. With our will, our creations. We never did frontline for XP. I've just never touched any of it, to be honest. Like... Your drill has a 5% chance to one-hit kill anyone for- Holy shit, really? That is... kind of nutty, actually. That is... That's pretty crazy. Oh, the star's beating heart, its life. Every soul a drop of blood flowing through its veins. That's said fun to play against, you kind of. Both said you just get ripped. It's like the fucking, it's like the fucking bees in Khan and shit like that. Final Sting moment. I've died to it, I can't even be mad. Honestly, yeah, fair. To live, to learn, to create, to make better. I get 5% proc, they earned it, I guess. Roll the dice. Star flourished as this way. We. Do you remember? The 21st night of September? As the whispers die, the final spirit fades. No shadows of time's long lost remain around the drowning brand. What? Buppy? I'm confused. Why is there glowing Buppy? Usually lustrous dog is gazing at you with what seems to be fond anticipation. Excuse me? I'm sending that to Luca. Now, just not a full screenshot, just the text, because I need to send that even contextless to him. That's. I will say that this is probably my second favorite map in the expansion. It's so beautiful. And I currently have a selfie pic of me and my wife's characters on this map as my desktop background. Aw, that's adorable! It appears to be waiting for you to follow it. Alright. I guess. Is it time to meet Benui? That's what I'm wondering. I'm gonna meet some Benuis. At some point. Huh? Points? Well, it also doesn't work. It broke. Well, she did it the other day and it broke. I need to figure out how to fix it. And I didn't quite... It still catches everyone off guard, yeah. But yeah, I still need to fix it. I didn't get a chance to fix it yesterday like I was hoping. Follow the dog and try not to fall behind. Oh, okay. Follow the dog. Where are we going, friend? I mean, how would this not catch someone off guard? It's like there's spoilers about Benuis everywhere because people love to make cute art of them, which is understandable. But this is just like not a thing that has come up in anything that anyone has posted ever, which I think I'm glad. I'm definitely glad for, but it just makes it a big surprise. It's like, oh, duck. Excuse me. But yeah, this area is kind of amazing. I can't wait to see what your first favorite map is, though, because I imagine that will be rather incredible to see. I'm so sad I've only got like an hour and a half to do more of this game. Favorite map is the last one. That does make sense. Like Azazelar in Heavenswood. Like, I love Heavenswood overall, but Azazelar is just like my aesthetic. I love that shit because I'm like a big fan of like the Forerunners in Halo, and their technology is probably my favorite. Well, maybe, I don't know. It's like a toss up between the Forerunners and the Covenant for me in that. But like the point is, because I love the Forerunner shit, I love like stuff like Azazelar or that Allegaan tech. And then when you get to the absolute last quest of the vanilla storyline. Right. Okay. Wow, really? That's when the main song for the map starts playing and Lilla gets me. Ah. Dog silently regards the spirit that lurks near the brand. Okay. We and the star were fulfilled. Wanted for naught, mourned for naught. Why? Why did it have to end? Oh, that's a lot of... Right, yeah. Oh yeah, well, I'm glad you know the thing as well. I'm just focusing down now. Not that one. Oh no. Didn't mean to right click on the damn spirit. More pressing that as a hand. Yeah. I mean, that song and the scene couldn't be better for the end of Storyline started in 1.0. Oh! Are you a 1.0 player? Hell yeah. Final days taught us to fear a death forced upon us. The injustice of duties and dreams left unfulfilled, the grief of unexpected partings. Swift as darkness, cold as ash. Such tragedy, yet no catharsis. Such truth, yet no consolation. Not 1.0 player, I started just prior to Heavensward, but Endwalker finishes the... Yeah, and I knew that part, but I wasn't... Okay, I guess you've like looked into the 1.0 stuff. I have only started... I think between 6.1 and 6.2, so I'm very, very recent player to the game, but I've been, like, looking into a lot of, like, the old stuff, like, you know, a lot of the old stuff, little bits of, like, 1.0 stuff, and now that I've cleared Shadowbringers, a little bit of the Shadowbringers lore, and, you know, and stuff, and lore from stuff before it, but trying not to see anything that's Endwalker related, but, you know, as the whispers die, the spirit fades, all is silent and still around the numbing brand, but yeah, and I ended up watching Yana's reaction video to the announcement for Endwalker, as well as I ended up quite a while ago, before I got to Heavenswood, accidentally watching the Endwalker trailer video, which was a big mistake. But I basically don't know anything. I didn't know anything after that point. And yes, feel free to ask those two questions. Ask away. Go for it. Dog. Shadow once again, staring at you expectantly. Who are you to deny it? Follow. Try not to fall behind. Where the hell are we going? This way? That's going to make a degree of sense, given it's the one crossing point here, but hey. Oh! Before I run so I can read this. There's an opinion of Shadowbringers, since a lot of people debate on either that or Endwalker being the best expansion. I think of my ultimate favorite character being Emmett Sepp. Ooh, okay. Shadowbringers is top tier shit. I loved it. It's really good. I suppose I would, in order to compare them myself, I would need to finish Endwalker, but I did really enjoy Shadowbringers. Like, holy shit, that was a fucking phenomenal. Also, Emmett is amazing. I love him very much, so I completely understand. Emmett is pretty fucking good, honestly. Anguish Spirit. Hello there. My perfection came crumbling down. Such overwhelming despair. In that moment we knew the end was nigh. So Shadowbringers is far better for the storyline and Walker's, but Walker's cutscenes kind of cinematic explosion. Shadowbringers out of the water. Fair, fair. Faintest glimmer of hope remained. We gave our lives that others may live. We gave ourselves to Zodiac. Honestly, that is fair, because they did have 2 years to like improve upon honestly phenomenal ability to use those in Shadowbringers. Like, yeah, like seeing the jump from like, you know, Realm Reborn to Heavenswood. Okay, pretty cool. Jump to Heavenswood to Stormblood. All right, they're starting to do some neat stuff. To Shadowbringers, holy fuck, this is like real ass like cinematics and shit. I love that. And now, the little bits that I've seen here are in Endwalker are kind of incredible. But I still only in like the front third of it, so you know, we'll see how it go. Zodiac, our lord and savior. I'm gonna just skip Stormblood though. I kind of ended up like hyperspeeding it in terms of streams. I played it during a they're talking and just kind of doing stuff. I ended up playing it during a break I ended up needing to take from streaming. But I did enjoy it at least. It was pretty good. Like, it was still fun. I can love again. Oh, what do I want? Oh no. There's like 6 quintillion of them. What do I do? Become one with the star. Fill earth and heaven with life. Birth paradise where fear is distant memory. I'm scared. I did end up doing big chunks of Shadowbringers just kind of offline by myself, since I could. But yeah. And maybe, would you be so kind as to step aside? Here's my boy. Wait! What do you mean? Wait, is he back? Unmistakable color. The soul of a Zen. It's my boy! He's back! I love him as well. I'm gonna be honest with you. Emmett is a good boy. Not the friend I knew, I think. Nevertheless, you are you. So Emmett's so meant for you to have it. Oh, no. I'm sad. So Emmett's so meant for you to have it. That's someone you've met before. Ethlodeus? Is that here? I'm surprised. Where might that be? They reset a receptionist again. I love that you can do that a second time. Again, I do not believe I have yet had the pleasure. Oh, I see. Oh, that's kind of excellent. That cell created a shade in my likeness, and not only me, but all of Emerald. How very like him. Slave to sentiment, even after an eternity. I gotta say though, Warrior of Lightfight, the Emmett reoccurrence was like eight elevated, like the Warrior of Lightfight, absolutely incredible trial, fucking phenomenal. But that little Emmett moment elevated it up to transcendent for me personally, because I don't know, like I've that whole bit, like five, like the whole patches segment up to 5.3. Yeah, understandable. But, like, that made me, like Elitibus, whereas previously I'd thought he was just a stupid motherfucker and I wanted to just slap him. Whereas Emmett, I was kind of like, oh, this guy is a thing, innit? But, I don't know, that kind of made me like Elitibus quite a bit more. It's still funny that, like, La Habrea having been deleted from existence is, means that we don't really get to interact with him knowing what we know. But, oh well. Maybe things in the patches. Based on the picture for the patches, I can tell that it has stuff to do with, like, Amarot and the old, like, you know, all of that old stuff. Because I can see the masks. I can see them. I can tell that they're related to that. I just want to know if we get some Laha. Some Lahi? Anyway. You could argue that Emmett Silk was a hero. Yeah, kinda. That's the weird thing. So you may have guessed, I am different from the shade you met before. No mere approximation, but the original. Yeah, that's, it's nice to actually meet you for real then, I guess. Soul sacrificed to Zodiac. Man. We remember in vivid detail the events leading to our purgatory. I don't want to cut off the voice acting, even if it is just, like, unintelligible. The plans and plots for our resurrection, Heidelin's intervention, and Zodiac's and the Star's final fate. I can learn knowledge. Oh, fuck, I didn't end up doing the thing anyway. And we drifted in a waking dream, our minds steeped in fog, until you came. Sometimes it's real fast, sometimes it just isn't. I know not what you and your friends intend for Zodiac, or the future of the Star. Nevertheless, in you I place my trust and faith. In you I choose to believe, as Emmett Selk did. Hell yeah. Honestly, if... especially given Fandaniel's personality and inclination, I honestly wonder what would happen if we were to bring back even portions of, like, Elitibus and Emmett. Like, what would happen? How would they react to the situation as it stands at this point? And, I don't know, maybe something will come up that'll be really fucking cool related to that, but I don't know yet. But, like, I really kind of hope something does, because I really like them, and they're neat. Believe in yourself, and all will be well. Thanks, man. I appreciate it. More new rivals, though. Ah, Fandaniel. That color I know. What a bitch. Fandaniel was a stupid bitch. Another I do not. An unfamiliar but fearsome being. Wait, he doesn't recognize Sinus' soul? Interesting. I've kept you from your duty. By way of apology, I will ensure that the shades hinder you no more. Protect the final brand. Fare you well, my new old friend. King. But yeah, no, I'd... like... yeah. Emmett was much more of... much more dealable and more of a hero than, you know... ooh, a lunar tender, that's what that's called. Oh, like a saber tender, but okay. That is very, they're very strange. Things raise the lustrous dog's hackles. Gee, I wonder, how could I have known it was them? Wow. Dog growls, agitated. Friend. Is it a boy? Energy with its nose, you get a feeling it wants you to hop on. Let's do, ride the dog. Let's go! Ride the dog! Yes! I say this is someone who has bought the fucking Mega Shiba. Riding the dog is always the most excellent way. Striking brand to the biting brand. Which one am I protecting? This one, I guess. What striking brand? Is that the only one that's intact still? Shit. All right, let's see what happens. Oh, I'm scared. I'm real scared, friends. My guess, based on what has been said by them, is that Xenos intends to eat Zodiac to become as powerful as possible to fight me or something. But which is, of course, insane, but, you know. Ah. Shit. That's... Say it's insane. To be honest. It's a Xenos Fandaniel play. Yeah, it's both of them. Neither of them are. Gotta say, during Shadowbringers, while Xenos was on Body Quest, I was all for him, and I was like on his side on it, but then seeing what he's been doing since then, I'm like, maybe that was a mistake. What's happening? Oh, this is bad, right? This is real bad, isn't it? But this is also level like 83! Wait! Hang on, I'm so... Okay. Alright.
Wanting for guidance.
Let's drink some water.
Powerful. Oh, so powerful. Ah. More so with every passing moment. Such potential. Even in this incomplete state. Still the savior who delivered a world from certain doom.
So, here we stand.
And standing here, I realize I want to fucking clap you real hard.
You know my intent. Consume the god, then the world. Stoke your fury to a raging inferno and dance among the ashes. Or perhaps you would face me here now. A lesser but welcome amusement.
I'll fight your croissant. And my axe.
A taste to whet the appetite.
Sorry to spoil the moment, but might I ask that you postpone the slaughter until I've said my piece? I promise I will be brief.
Hi, Zara. I'm not looking forward to seeing you. Oh, thank you.
And take everyone with me. I meant it.
Thanks for stopping by, though, Zara. It's good to see you. Good. What does he mean? He wants to. What is he saying? What? Wait. No. You son of a bitch. I'm gonna have to work with Xenos to deal with this, aren't I? Oh, God damn it! My fucking God. a savior. That's Nebrialis, right? Guardian, the keeper of natural water. Yeah, the martyr. The bestower of new beginnings. Uh-oh. We are.
Such lofty aspirations. And what sweet irony that the world's saviors will become the agents of its destruction.
Cannot end this way. We must return and be made whole. By the will of the star, now and forever. Oh boy! For the greater good, for the sake of the world. I'm scared as to what's gonna happen next. Of you. Star must endure. God bless Fenrir's voice actor for his amazing performance. I know, it's honestly, yeah. Because so there was one thing I struggled a little bit with in my last play session, my big 9-hour stream, was because I noticed at some point when he started talking like, wait, who, what?
Believe. Walk in faith. Let the light of your soul shine for all to see.
My lord! He's here! I love you, sir. Words. Brain. I want to finish the thought I had before I progress. Is it the same voice actor as Asahi? Because at one point he changed and then it sounded like he was doing a different voice that didn't sound like the Asahi voice he was doing. And I'm just trying to figure out if it's still the same guy because I figure it must be. Okay, cool. Alright, good. I'm glad. I don't know, for some reason I was just like, that sounds different in like a fundamental way I can't explain. I don't know, after the like bit where he was like, oh. Yeah, he would be. Like, it makes sense, you know, giving us the body and everything, and it's like, it makes sense that it's still the same VA, but there was, and like, it was definitely was at the start, 100%, I could tell, but there was just a point after that cinematic where you go back and, you know, he's like, the other voice actor is speaking because it's supposed to represent Amon, like, after that point, the Asahi voice came out a bit, it sounded a bit different, if that makes sense, a little bit fundamentally different. I don't know, maybe he did something a bit different with it, but either way, it's cool, it's very good. But wait, it's not who I think it is? Wait, what?
Not quite the outcome you'd imagined, but a fitting one nonetheless.
Wait, what the fuck?
Don't you think so, Hades?
What? That sounded like... What? 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 I'm so confused. Challenge, be straight, the object in your way, that guy. We're doing this. Good. Now kill Zodiac. Yep, that's... Okay. I must admit this moment has come sooner than I anticipated. I'm on board. I'm on board, though. Surely you summoned the boys for this one. Yeah, fucking get in here, you fool. I'll do it. And this is when this game came out, the fan up blew up during this part. Yeah, no shit. I can imagine, I'm gonna be honest with you. For friend list. Where are we dropping? In the stream Discord? You want in? I thought the big bad boss was... Yeah. Like, that's the thing. That's what I'm surprised about as well. And I'll see you in the stream room. Let's go. Come on, friend. I'm there now. Yeah. What are we gonna sub because of you now?
Hello?
Hello and welcome. I gotta reappear the fucking... the little melon. There we go. There you are. You're here now. You're visible. Can I just say the extreme fight on this when it was new was fun as hell. Oh, hell yeah. Alright.
I haven't done that extreme in forever.
Oof. Do we have other people anyone we should invite, or just us? I don't know who else to invite, because I didn't see anyone else online, to be honest.
Okay.
Yeah, there's like no one else that I can see.
Unlucky.
Oh well, it's fine, we'll do it. It's okay, Doc, and I love me my cats. Alright, the dank inside. Time to get absolutely rat-fucked by a thick lad.
Yeah, surely we get a queue at 4 o'clock on Tuesday.
It is Tuesday, right? For some reason I thought it was Wednesday. I don't know why I thought that. It took me like 40 minutes to scrape a group together because I got too thin at like 4 in the morning. I was into this at the first day of launch. Damn. Nice. But also feels bad about that queue. I hate having like getting up to cool moments like this and then having like super long queues. It took a bit because I was running Reaper and so did everyone else. Oof. That's why I'm glad I'm maining a tank, to be honest. Oh, man. I was not expecting this, to be honest.
Yeah, it does happen a lot faster than you'd be expecting. Like, first Garlemald, and then this.
Like, yeah, no, but I mean, I knew Garlemald was kind of soon-ish. I didn't realize it'd be quite as soon, I guess, but like, not that much sooner than I anticipated, I guess, if that makes sense. Then again, I guess we are still in, like, the 83... So, yeah, definitely, I guess it is... I kind of expected, like, 85-ish, thereabouts. But, not 80-fucking-2 or whatever it was. Damn. Yeah, this is,
Yeah, this fight's pretty cool. They got some wild in the arena mechanics going on.
I am going to die. Which brings up a lot of questions like, where do you go from here? What about Xenos? Who was that person talking to you? What the fuck is up with that dog? Yeah, pretty much. There's a lot of, there's a lot of unanswered questions all considered. One thing that I have been spoiled a couple of times by thumbnails is the fact that there is a boss called the Endsinger. I don't know what it is or what it does because I very specifically not clicked on them. But YouTube's recommendation algorithm is fucking relentless. So, I have seen that a couple of times and know it exists. Yeah, I know it's coming. I don't know what it is or why or anything. Based on its name, I'm scared, though. But I'm like, well, you know, there's also a whole lot of what is it and what's on the way there. And also, I haven't met the fucking Banuis yet. I know that's happening. That's gonna happen. And I'm excited. I'm fucking excited to find out. I want to meet Banui. Because they're all cute and shit, right? I've seen, like, art come up a lot on, like, Twitter and stuff. And they're adorable. Ah, yes, the bunnies. I just keep writing it as, like... I keep saying it and... Why is it telling me to follow my chat rules in my own chat? Damn. I keep saying it as, like, Banui. Oh yeah, like ages ago. In fact, it's the only thing that my friend Luca knows about Endwalker as well. Like he's seen like art come up for them a bunch, so like he knows that they are a concept, and was also spoiled on the moon because of an intro, like a beginner level video that someone produced for this game involved a clip of them being on the moon. So he was like, "What the fuck? Like, why would you include that?" But yeah, I can't wait to meet the bunnies. It'll be a great time. So on a scale of 1 to 53, how fucking hard is this guy?
He's not really that hard. Like, you, okay. you can follow the leader on this one.
Alright.
The Dorito of knowledge on then.
Yeah. Did you say put the Dorito of knowledge on someone?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
So, in this game, you can when you're in a duty, you can mark people. Like, you can give them an icon over their head.
Yep.
So, at least my group's taken to calling it the Dorito of knowledge. So you put it on top of, you put it on the head of the person who knows what they're doing, and everyone follow that guy.
Is it like just the triangle out of like the PlayStation symbols?
Yeah.
Okay. He's a 5 out of a 53 EOS. Are you sure? Really? Wait. It's like, yes, this guy they've been building up to since the end of Realm Reborn. He is a 5 out of 53. Excuse me.
He is really cool, but he's not that hard.
Fair. Oh. Honestly, the worst part about being in a queue for a duty like this is because you're in a queue for a duty, you can't, like, do a roulette while you wait or something. It's like, it's a 5 because Melon is right there. This fight essentially comes down to follow the leader. Right. Okay. Specifics. Okay. I see. So,
that's assuming if we can, if everyone knows what, you know, what the spot is. It's been a while.
Mm-hmm. It's this song. The Wings of Hope one, right? Eventually avoid 99% of the damage minus auto attacks. Okay. Just, I love the fucking Dorito of Knowledge name, though. It's so good. Oh...
Sorry, we found one gamer out of 5.
One singular, excellent. Out of 6, even, you mean. That's the worst part.
Do you think it'll be faster to party finders?
I don't know. I'm also... I've never actually used party finder. I'm calling it the danger Dorito. He's suicidal and try to kill others. Ah, I see. I want to do Palace of the Dead at some point. I want to know what that's like. I want to try it. I ended up looking into, like, that character Edda from the, like, the early Realm Reborn. That one party where she, you know, the tank gets killed and then...
Getting fucking abused by her party members?
Yeah, getting abused by her party members and then brings back her fucking dead husband, like, and whatever. And I just, like, I ended up seeing on her page, oh yeah, she comes back in Palace of the Dead. And I'm like, oh hell yeah. I kind of want to see that, because that, like, ends off her storyline and shit. Yeah, that's honestly fair if you did it way too much. Especially since they added more to it in Stormblood, right? Like,
yeah,
I saw there was a quest. High. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm.
I haven't actually done any of them. I kind of wanted, but...
Do I need to make you leader for a party finder thing to be made, or because
no, you can make it if you want to.
I basically just don't know.
Just in the bottom left, go recruit members.
Yeah. Judy, trials, the dank inside. Yep, that's the one.
Yeah, and then you can just put a description and be like, you know,
in comment. You mean
completion, send help, something like that. Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah.
Should I just do it?
Yeah.
And then in which case do I withdraw from the, like, forming as well?
Yeah. Just hit recruit members and it should be fine, right? I don't know how it interacts if you're...
Like, yeah, it just says I have to withdraw first in order to do it. Okay. So, I guess I'll do that. And then... Trials, Dark Inside, MSQ completion, send help, recruit members, done. For the grand cosmos. The dank inside. I am excited. The question is, what do I do in the meantime?
An excellent question. You can craft.
I can craft? I can just stand in front of Zodiac and craft. What? Oh, I see. I was like, wait, what's G-pose again? And I'm like, oh, this. That's right.
Take pictures.
Take all of the pictures. How do I take a photo? Is it just... How do I exit G-pose again? I don't know what I'm doing and I'm kind of scared I'll miss. Okay, that's it. Cool. I could do that.
There's no queue pop. People will just join the party and then you can queue up whenever you're ready.
Right, right. I do not have Bard. I would have to obtain Bard first in order for that to happen. Luca picked up Bard purely to get to, like, the instruments and then, like, stopped. Do I leave the Dark Inside?
Yeah, you can go wherever you want now.
Yeah, I can kind of go wherever now. Yeah. I can just explore the Sea of the Mare Elementorum, right?
Yes, you can.
I can go pick up bits of map. Maybe even do random quests on some of my lower level classes and jobs. Ooh. Little bits of... Oh yes, this theme music. Excuse me? You're gonna pop that little bit of the map game? I'm well and truly within this section. You gonna do the thing? Am I gonna go fuck myself, I guess, instead? That's fine, that's fair. I wanna just see the moon. Zodiac, I know you just got reborn and want to fight me as well as being a huge threat. You'd be a good boy and stay down there for me to explore the moon some more.
It's every JRPG ever.
Yeah.
Oh, the world's about to die. We're all in imminent peril. The villain's got some, like, gigantic super magic that's gonna destroy the world. I need to save this chicken.
Oh. It really is. I have limited experience with JRPGs, but I've played enough of them to be like, that is definitely correct. Why is it not popping this bit of the map? Ah! Please! Game! I was well and truly there. This is bullshit. I'm like, flying for that map piece. Oh! There's someone. We take those. I have about 40 minutes. I hope we will be fine. That's true.
Okay, what? Once people start joining, it's cascade, okay? Curb. Cascade. Once you get more people will start joining because they see the party's full.
Ah, I see. This is good. Imagine unlocking flying though, holy shit. Ugh. I am excited. I'll say this for waiting. You want to share your thoughts and experiences so far? I'm really enjoying it. I love it. I love that we've got to go to Garlemald because that's something I wanted to do even back in as far as Realm Reborn content. That's honestly understandable. It's pretty fucking good, I would say. This game is really good, and I'm glad I was eventually convinced to play it because I definitely put it off for way too long. But I'm glad I'm finally playing it, and this expansion is fucking lit. Oh my god, it's so good! Man. The one and only downside, though a very understandable one, let's face it, is the fact that, like, I kind of got used to the way Warframe did things for, like, with people where you didn't have to pick, like, a data center and server and whatnot, and we could just kind of... people could just kind of play together. And then its netcode was, like, surprisingly good, given it was, like, a shooting game and everything as well. And, I am kind of sad that I can't just, like, play with people, you know, like Eos, like Lyra, like whoever's just in the American servers or the Japanese servers or whatever. Just, that's the one downside I'm finding, but
the game itself is so good. The data center transfer, but I'm not sure exactly what the timeline is on it.
That's the thing, they gotta, they, you know, we can play. Russ, well, the problem is, because we're in the Oceania data server, it is, like, super isolated because you can only data center transfer within, like, a region. Like, all the Japanese ones you can transfer between them, all the US ones you can transfer between those, but you can't go to, like, from the, like, the US to Europe or, you know, Oceania to literally fucking anywhere. I wish you could, but no. It's a solid rip. Yeah, it's a little unfortunate. I remember when it was like first ad and everyone was excited and they were like, no. It's like they're no, actually, unfortunately we haven't been able to fully do it yet. We have a healer. What did Popey join as? I didn't notice, and now they're fishing, so... Okay, cool. That's good. We have two healers, two tanks, and a DPS. I'm
surprised they fill up on support classes before DPS classes. But
yeah. But yeah. But yeah, Eos, it's a big rip, because otherwise I would absolutely love to play with you as well. Call in the friends for the fucking mega... Just ganking the Dark God. Let's do it. It'll be great. How do people put the little arrows in... the chat. I see that all the time and I just have no idea what it is.
So what you need to do is you start typing something and you press tab and that brings up the autocomplete
function. I see.
So the little arrows is an auto translate. So if your client was in Japanese, that would come up as Japanese, whatever's inside the little arrows.
Oh, that's cool. If I want to needs to get that one rare fish, he almost has it. He was like 5 minutes. It is JRPGs, truly.
My legendary nerd.
I need it. I need it. I've seen a meme. It's not quite that. It's one of the, it's like, what if we kissed near the level 80, like, legendary bush or whatever it was. It was just, like, really stupid. I love shit like that. Just, like, dumb little things. I have no idea. Can I... How do I go to and from this location if I leave it? I probably can't, can I?
What, the moon?
This particular part of the moon.
You need to get on the dog.
No, I need to stop you from doing this matter anyway. I didn't finish them before then. I see. Ah, here we go. That's why, because I'm dumb. That's what this was. This was. The dog will return me to Zodi. Zodi-odi. That is kind of wild that we did get the two healers and tanks before before the DPS ends. And with this, like, real, just, like, you know, like, things are important right now kind of music going on as well. We're just like, I see. Five or more levels above. Ah, yes, because I am level fucking 88. Oh, man. That's why you're waiting. I can make a request from you, my new old friend. Yeah. Absolutely. Let's go. What's up? What you got for me? What have we got? What are we doing? What am I doing? Who am I? What am I fighting for? Etc.
Okay.
I'll try. I've already made a promise to Melon here that I will stream all of Endwalker MSQ because of, especially because I didn't for Shadowbringers and whatnot. So at worst, there will be VODs, and I do send them to YouTube. They just take a while to, for me to then, like, make them public view. I do have a YouTube channel that I used to actually make videos for. Crazy, but then I just... Editing is pain, so that's why I stream now. Because I don't enjoy editing. It's not fun. Nor can I really afford to hire an editor. But I will let you know when I get to it. But if for whatever reason you can't watch at that point, you can definitely watch it. I understand why I'm asking. Yeah, I'm guessing so. I'm spooked. I'm just a little bit spooked. Oh. I'm tempted to, like, go down to Garlemald and do some random fates to, like, you know, get gemstones and level fucking Astro, but that's also probably a terrible idea. I don't know what to do.
You can buy some crafting materials with the black color gemstones and sell them.
That is an option. Oh yeah, actually,
all the high end raid food is crafted with
gemstone stuff. Well, my crafting classes are a little behind my actual classes, since that I still up to like 73 as the highest for those, and culinarian is down at 32. I'm gonna hang on. I don't know why auto mod. There we go. but yes. Either way, yeah, it's that would be. Now I genuinely want to fucking know what would happen. <That's> actually... Just like, because, like, is he still kind of like stuck in the moon now? Because, like, that would be really funny. It's like, I could fight you, or I could just let you be here and suffer.
Yeah.
Oh, it's all good. He is stuck? Oh, excellent. Yeah, all good ears, don't worry. But yeah. But that is extremely funny. Oh, I'm. You've just reminded me of something I read once that was just pain. You know how there's a lot of, like, phrases and bits and pieces that people often get, like, wrong? Like, for all intents and purposes. Some people do it for all intensive purposes. And it's just, like... I remember reading this, like, big long paragraph of someone who used a lot of those very incorrectly, and it made me want to die. It was bad. Ugh. Oh man, man, oh man. Do you think we could unsync it with five people?
With tanks and healers? Yeah, maybe.
I would like at least maybe, a one more
maybe,
DPS.
Maybe with tanks and healers. I think we could just go to the normal, like, queue. Maybe we'll find some.
Should I ask him in chat?
Yeah, you can ask if, like, if you guys want to queue up with this and...
Oh! There's no enrage timer in normal. Oh, that is good, actually.
Yeah.
Oh! 7 even. Alright.
Alright, one more.
Be a battle of attrition, right? This is going well. I've been saying I've been doing the salute for everyone except for this last person, where I'm just like, ah, yes, just one more. We're so close. You could sure unsync it now and be fine. I feel like we could just queue it now, even, right?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you can ask if you guys want to, if they want to queue up.
Hmm. longer wait for. Hope you to definitely be back in healing mode. One sec. Wow, it's like they fucking heard me, damn. oh man, it's fucking... I'm so hyped. Gotta get the fish.
Gotta get the fish.
Fish important if you want to make food and stuff, I guess.
Okay.
Alright, like... let's fucking do it. Confront Zodiac in the dark inside. Yeet! No, wait, no, I'm unable to participate in duty while looking for a party. What? Quit using the party finder.
Yeah.
I can add for WoW as I'm watching this game. Oof. Just do it. Do I just do it? Like, go?
Yeah, just hit quit using the party finder, yeah.
Yes? Alright.
Yeah. And just put us in the queue. Surely you'll be able to find one person.
There we go! One DPS was all we needed. Eternal Darkness Zodiac. It can't be that eternal if he's only level 80 fucking 3, you stupid bitch. Like, should I?
Don't really matter, I think. Alright, make decision. If you want a tank, you'll turn on tank stance.
Yep. Alright, let's do it. I'm trying to fucking... Did I do it? Let's go.
Yeah, you did it.
Yeet! Alright, so we gotta follow the leader, right? Oh, I fucking forgot to change my HUD layout. Oh no, I'm fucked. Oh god. Over here? Okay. About to get tank busted. HUD layout! Number two! Quickly! Done! Okay, I can see the game now. That's much better.
Over and stay on this side.
Which side?
Down side.
Oh, this side? Okay. Because I see the fucking... Yep, I see the AoE. What is he doing now? Is he making something? Is he making an ad? No, he's just fucking declaring himself.
Making some explosions.
Ooh. A behemoth concept is brought into creation. What does that fucking mean? Oh, okay. I'm gonna get out of there. Ah, I see now. It turns out I can get enough buffs to, like, have it stack over the fucking boss's health bar. Super stack, let's go! I threw down a quick fucking reprisal on him just before he started clapping us. Hopefully that helps in some way. Remember the fucking remember the days of reprisal crashing my laptop.
Over this corner.
Over here? Okay. I have it at times played this game on an old laptop, and for a while the install was broken, and anyone using Reprisal remotely close to me, whether it was me or someone else, would literally just crash the whole game. Just completely whole ass, just gone. Like an alt F4. Oh fuck, what's happening now?
He's doing the thing.
I love that the fucking Lala managed to get like a pose in just before that happened. It's so good. He's busting out. And Adonis seems pretty bright to me. Yeah. At last, I am become Zodiac. Are you sure about that? Are you sure about that? Seemed pretty incomplete, my dude. Oh fuck, that's not good.
Over here.
Over there? Isn't that where the fucking... Oh, right, because there's a thing here in the way. Oh, what's happening now? We're chained? Okay, not anymore, I guess. I barely avoided that, huh? Fuck's sake, I think I just got hit by one. Feels bad, like an idiot.
Oh, okay, well. Go to the side ones first, and then cross over to the middle.
The side ones first?
Yeah.
And then cross to the middle. Oh fuck, I got hit by the middle, barely. I will use a mitigation, given I now have two stacks. What? Oh my god, I barely avoided it. I barely avoided it, holy shit. I, like, just barely. And I've been having a lot of, like, lag recently as well, so I'm real happy that I managed to avoid that just as quickly as as close as I did, rather. What is he? Oh, he's doing the spin shit again, huh? He's spinning to winning! No! No! Oh. I got mega baited. I haven't needed to use any of my self heal yet, which I will take as a good sign.
I forget how this one works.
There's an arrow coming this way.
I think here.
Where are you? Oh, I got hit. Oops, he said, I think here, and so I ran to you and immediately died. Beautiful. Oops. Don't expect it from a first timer. That's, you know what, fair. Or is it a bait? Is it a massive bait? I'm confused. Oh, the big thing. That kind of thing. Bait. I have my full health. Oh, cool. Oh, I accidentally fucking tabbed out. No, we're good. Alright, I fixed it. Wow. Well, that certainly does do a lot of fucking damage. We are doing okay.
Can't see.
Are we going up the middle? Oh, I got hit by that. I got hit by one of those. Not least it wasn't both, if nothing else.
Left side first, and then front.
Did I just hear someone limit break?
Yeah.
Is it the tank one?
The LV3. No. It was a ninja limit break.
Ah. Oh. Nice, nice. Do some damage. He's taking it. He's taking it in the face. Like, he damn well should, you stupid motherfucker. Oh, thank god, I was in the safe spot. I was in the safe zone. Oh my god, my fucking Vuln stack has a visible timer. I might actually live through that. I might actually get through it without getting another one this time. Because this kind of unavoidable stuff doesn't give you Vuln stacks, right? Like, it's my understanding.
No. You don't get punished for doing the mechanic properly.
Yeah. I thought so, but I wasn't, like, 100. I was like, I don't know. It's always good to be sure.
So middle first, and then cross the outside.
Somehow I managed it this time. Got the timing right. Ah! I want to destroy him! We did it!
This guy about to get 7 commands.
Damn. See a 5 on difficulty. Surprisingly so. I did die, but yes. Who can I commend? Shorty Ringo, I'll do it. I'll take it. I received 1. How many did you get?
No, we went in a stack of 7, so we can't commend.
Oh, right, that's true, we can't.
The only person all 7 of us could commend was the random.
Yeah! But I got it from Shorty at least, I'll take it. Damn. Damn, you're right, Zodiac a bitch. Well done, my preparations are complete and I stand ready to seal Zodiac once more. Okay. Damn, that was... Withdraw from the now from this place. The teleporter will deliver you to safety. Xenos is gonna pull some shit and like, you know. You say that now that you've lost. You left my best laid plans in ruins. And played your role to perfection. Thus, sealing my victory. What the fuck? Uh-oh. What is he doing? Huh. What better and more satisfying way to ensure success than to take control myself? But like, you ruined everything. I mean, of course that happened. Yes, of course. He did, apparently. Live to tell the tale. Even so, I have fulfilled my heart's desire. Right, because Zodiac was the one that stopped the final days from happening, right? So by killing Zodiac, we reoccur the final days, is my guess. Oh god, I hope I'm wrong. Uh-oh. Have I fucked up? Oh, shit. Per se, think of the fun day, something that's always gonna happen. Right. Fades, and blood cools. Different text box. Old familiar sensations. So they put a temporary pause on it. Oh! So many lives, so many deaths. No different this. I close my eyes and slip. Into the dreamless slumber. With a different text box. I do remember that actually, wasn't it? In Amarok, I think? A tired song and dance. Routine. Always I wake. But not this time. Nothing left unsaid. Nothing left undone. Inherit my hell. I intone with glee. The man I was would weep
for what I have become. The all-consuming contempt. But I've the wisdom of 10 millennia to justify my answer to the question. No value in their existence. Not a whit. For all that I looked, none that I did see. A final chance, then, for Hydaelyn and her faithful. In Cataclysm, prove me wrong. I sneer. All shall return to nothingness, as was your will, Emperor Zande. I, the star, and every living being, consigned to your oblivion.
Well. Well, 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 well. Shit. I've fucked up and I've caused the apocalypse. Maybe. Ballin, but at what cost?
At last.
What is happening? What is happening? Slow and steady. Okay, planet looks fine. For the moment. Saw it too, yes. The blue star below, thrown into turmoil. Yep, I saw it! Was no illusion. All was truth. Yep, I guess it. I guess that's the case. With the death of Zodiac, laws of nature over which he presided have begun to unravel. The final days are upon us. I guess so. What you witnessed was an omen granted by the Echo, a vision of the horrors to come. No, no, right. The world didn't change except Rian Janes speaks with a posh British accent, and that is the true final days. What?
Eh?
Time grows short. Is Xenos coming out of the pit right now? Did Xenos just eat some of Zodiac's power to come back down and attempt that? Yep. Xenos, please, can we put this on hold, please? Thank you. That would be nice. Do I really gotta fight you now, my man? Now is the worst time for it.
No.
He did eat Zodiac's power, I'm guessing, given his this-ness. Heard you. Good. I'm glad.
Slavering beasts gather at your gates, ravenous and eager. Already you turn to them and away from me. Ah. I must go forth once more in search of power far beyond the might of Shinryu. Power to make your heart run over with rage.
Or you could just help.
The rage to primals was a betrayal of promise. A pathetic creature incapable of inspiring true despair. That's what I crave.
It's true. Pure,
unadulterated despair.
I will not fight for your amusement. I'm gonna shoot you down, man. I know it's upsetting, but curves his pair.
We shall see.
He craves this pair. Okay, get it now. That's pretty good. He looks like he sheds one manly tear. I should have told him I'll fight him if he helps me at Lamau. It's like, buddy, I'll fight you all you want if you help me. See, that's where you're going. There's a wall back there. It's like, I think it's the fucking Aetherite, probably. Sense his presence on the moon no longer. If you need not follow, then I beg you stay and listen to what I have to tell you. Of Zodiac and the end of all things. Rise up through the night. Weapon cover 533. Ooh, not sure if they mentioned that. Actually, busy saving the world during Shadowbringers. I saw him doing some stuff, but not really saving the world, per se. Before we speak at length, I believe a change of surrounds is in order. More than ill tidings, you see, I sense others arriving not long ago. Has he stopped the use of Black Rose? That is true. Oh no, because no, that was mostly Gaius and Astinian, right? That we're doing that. I guess he did, like, once he took over, he was just like, no Black Rose, fuck you, we're not doing that. And my communions with Heidelin of Green infrequent, I have learned enough from her to know these are your comrades. As luck would have it, they have already reached my abode. Come, let us join them. I got a good, like, 10 minutes to go through some cutscene stuff. I'm pretty happy with that. Oh, of course I got a fucking hand. Let me just mount up so it's faster. That is good, though. I do like that he did stop that. Even if he didn't do it for the same reason as Gaius, which is to say, that's fucking terrible. Let's not actually do that. It's funny going back to Rom Reborn Gaius and seeing how he's just, like, an evil shit boy. You know, with dreams of conquest or whatever. But then you, like, talk to him more later, and it's like, that, you know, learning more like, hey, yeah, no, chemical weapons is really bad, actually, let's not do that, and hey, yeah, let's not treat all of our subjects like shit, like complete shit, that's a really bad idea, actually. You know, just like, stuff that really doesn't come across so well in his Rom Reborn variant. I guess it kind of does with Rytotaine, and the fact that he's like, I elevated Rytotaine because he's good at his job, not because he's just Galleon or whatever, you know, even though he's not Galleon. Which I do think is good, if the one thing. They didn't have a whole lot of time. Yeah, that's true. I mean, it's good that they fleshed him out regardless. I'm still happy about that they did it all. Dare I ask what happened before we arrived? I presume this being is a native of the moon. So they are indeed the three I sensed. Cinematic. Goodness, you are unharmed. Damn, I was having a voice. To be fair, Gaius was technically a good guy in Rom Reborn. Galleon was trying to unify the world to prevent what just happened. I mean, I guess they were just doing it in very incorrectly and in a very bad imperialist way that I am not a fan of. Which is the problem. I guess. It's like Realm Reborn, though the enemy is imperialism, and also there happens to be a shitty, shady guy trying to break everything at the end. Everything else. Yeah, actually, the shitty, shady guys were the big problem. Imperialism isn't great and still needs to be stopped, but, like, it's just kind of a much lesser threat right now. Yeah, that was a bad way of doing so, but they were the most technologically advanced. Yeah, it's, you know, with their whole Magitek and everything, you know. They still had to be stopped because the imperialism was still very bad and needed to be stopped. We did what we could to subdue the Tempered before making our way here. Wish this was voiced, but eh. Not without casualties, unfortunately. Some few detonated explosives, killing themselves and others. The contingent's healers had their hands full turning to the injured and enthralled when we took our leave. Lest you wonder, Mistress Kryll hath also been delivered unto their care. Serving as a conduit for Heidelin's power hath taken its toll, but she will recover in due course. As for Alphino and Alice, they insist on remaining in Garlemald while we three rush to your aid. It appears, however, that matters here have already come to a conclusion. What matter of conclusion, if I might ask? And is this the ally whom Heidelin bade you seek out? He is not unlike the Shades of Amarat. Not unlike, perhaps, but not the same. I was created by Heidelin, together with this place. It has ever been my duty to keep vigil over Zodiac. Or rather, it was my duty. Leave one of the sidecasts expanded in the past, Garlemald did try to unify the world by peace, while optional treated as lesser beings due to lack of magical powers, forced technology to make them listen. Yeah, they've definitely mentioned at least the fact that they were definitely seen as lesser without magic and needed the technology, but not the tried to unify via peaceful options. I haven't seen that part yet, and it's, I guess it's good that they tried that. It sucks that they weren't able to, with the whole being looked down on thing. But, ugh. Strength. It's annoying. It's needed. Reasons. I just wish it... Ugh. Anyway. I guess I just now explain to them, hey, yeah, so that happened. A lot of bad shit, and it was kind of terrifying, honestly. My phone charging? It should be. I've got a family thing on tonight, and that's part of why it is very inescapable. Just make sure of something. And Zodiac is no more. Not without consequence, I'm afraid. For now the delicate weave of the star preserved by his presence will begin to unravel.
Oh, no!
If you mean to avert the final days, you shall have need of... Ooh. You're right. My attempts to forestall Zodiac's release have all but exhausted my strength. If you might allow me to rest a short while, I will share with you all I can. Please do, you need not exert yourself on our account. These crystals contain records of your time here, yes? May we peruse them while we wait? By all means, if you would review them chronologically, might I suggest beginning with those on the upper floor? I shall leave that to you, Lorelei, while I see what can be gleaned from the crystals on the lower, on these lower levels. On the upper floor, see if there's ought to be learned in here. Dang it, I want cool dialogue. Ah, my lips feel all weird and stuff. I love you, Ben. Okay, I'll be going soonish, by the way, so got a little bit to go. A few more minutes, easy. So don't defeat it. While he may have been in an incomplete state, that's nevertheless an impressive feat. Even if you hadn't, his demise was inevitable, and Daniel would have seen to it one way or another. Said he probably would have wielded Zodiac's power to wreak untold destruction before taking his own life, making this the better of two unfavorable outcomes. I suppose that's true, actually, yeah. Dost thou suppose our host hath maintained his solitary vigil since the very beginning, without rest or relief? If so, these records comprise the sum total of his existence. We must needs handle them with care. That's a good point. I wasn't intending to, like, break them or damage them or anything anyway, but, like, still. As you gaze into the crystal, ancient knowledge of Zodiac flows through your mind. Daily summary, no abnormalities detected. Here to be records of a long, lonely vigil on the moon, dating back to the beginning of Zodiac's imprisonment. I see. I'm glad that they use Neath Dark Waters for this section as well, because, like, for this area, because it is just a good song. Gazing the crystal knowledge of past calamities flows through your mind. Records describe how, with each rejoining, Zodiac's thirst for freedom grew, as did the strain on the brands. Maintaining Zodiac's imprisonment appears to tax Heidelin greatly. As you gaze into the crystal, knowledge of past rejoinings flows through your mind. The records describe the Watcher's efforts to prepare in the event Zodiac broke free from his prison. The records go on to describe maintenance carried out regularly with the Laporites, though it is not clear who or what they are. Rabbit! Rabbit! I recognize the name. Rabbit. At least I'm pretty sure it's the rabbits. I could just be wrong, but I think it's the rabbits. Gaze into the crystal, a record of an unexpected visitor flows through your mind. At the Watcher's musings when Elidibus is spotted on the moon, though clearly not for the first time. It's clear he and his brethren have taken a keen interest in freeing Zodiac from his prison, and yet they have made no attempt to destroy the brands. Perhaps they prefer he remain hidden from mortal eyes until the final rejoining. Perhaps they realize we would never dare bring harm to Zodiac so long as he remains imprisoned. Yeah, I suppose that was the case. Did you learn anything of import? So it was as we suspected. Maintaining the brands requires a great deal of her energy and focus, and this cost has grown higher with every rejoining. That would explain why contact with her has become rather infrequent since the Seventh Umbral Calamity. I too made a rather startling discovery. This heavenly body we know by the moon to be the moon, it was in fact created by Heidelin. When the Watcher said he was created together with this place, I thought he only meant this facility. Truly, Heidelin's powers are far beyond anything I could have imagined. I do find it funny how the Alagons really did just, like, try to copy pretty hard, which is why it's even funnier that Gallimald is trying hard to copy, Alag. Nothing is original anymore. I thank you for affording me this short reprieve. What you got for us, my man? By killing Zodiac, Ithlodeus is gone now too, isn't he? Now I'm sad.
It is we who should thank you. The records stored here are nothing short of extraordinary.
I'm terrified of that strange British accent you mentioned your Aranja having.
Much we could learn of Zodiac and his imprisonment, but perhaps you could offer us more focused guidance. Pray, tell us of the calamity that came before and comes now again.
Learning. Okay. Before the Great Sundering, there was but a single world. Aetherus. One day, from within the earth, a terrible cry issued forth, affecting a profound change in all manner of life. Oh, this song is also good. I'm gonna dream it around just since the earth got dark, but then went back to what it looked like prior. Oh, I see. Okay. I thought that maybe they actually changed his voice actor, since that is a thing that do happen sometimes. I see. We were not exempt. Our creation magics ran rampant, giving shape and form to thoughts of hopelessness and despair. And they learned the true name of the star. Aetherus. It's pretty good. Good name. First, the phenomenon was limited to a single region, but quickly, so very quickly, it spread and engulfed the whole of the star. Cut off the VA a little bit for this. Starting to run out of time. Yeah, I mean, the thing of the VA, at least. They were not. However, the Convocation struck upon a method to predict where the next corruption would manifest. Etheric energies which flow through all of creation in the form of various currents. The currents which course the land and seas. Those which flow through the very air. And those of a celestial nature which encompass both our star and this moon.
With the concept.
I feel like as an astro, I might be kind of familiar with the concept, but hey. What would I expect you to be? Few scholars of our time knew of their existence. Okay, never mind, I was wrong. Their invaluable knowledge helped us to better understand the nature of the calamity. Like the terrestrial ones of Earth and Air, the celestial currents form a vast network, but the ethereal distribution is not consistent. The Convocation soon realized that inciting incidents occurred in regions where the flow was weakest. Okay. Correlation without clear cause, ultimately. Nevertheless, on closer study, a stagnancy of ether was observed in nearby currents. Oh, right. That.
And so they sought a means to harness the forces of darkness, of activity and growth. Thus, was Zodiac conceived.
I see.
No power than a god's could set right the laws of nature and quicken the flow of ether within the star.
Precisely. With the advent of Zodiac, our end was averted.
Emmett Selk claimed that those who summoned Hydaelyn did so because they saw Zodiac's power as a threat. Is that true?
Indeed. There was a faction opposed to Zodiac's creation, but their aim was never to unmake him. They understood the continued preservation of the natural order was dependent on his very existence. Until we could identify and address the underlying cause of the final days, he would need remain, for his departure would set in motion those apocalyptic forces once more. Hydaelyn recognized this as well, and so, rather than destroy, she sundered Zodiac, herself, and the star into lesser reflections, that she might confine him in this place. This once she beseeched me to banish the darkness. Confused, yeah. Perhaps she did, but as with all beings, intent is not always in accord with spoken word. Hydaelyn and Zodiac are both constructs of man, approximations of perfection limited by our own imperfections. Zodiac was, without question, the more powerful of the two, having been born from the sacrifice of half of Aetherius' population. Thus was it necessary for Hydaelyn to commit herself wholly to his defeat. Still more effort was needed to confine him. Maintaining the brands taxed her greatly. With what power she dared spare, she cried out to any who might listen and offered her blessings to those who heeded her call. Though it was likely within her power to do so, I believe she did not wish to speak of Aetherus and her history. Like Zodiac, Heidelin's purpose is a reflection of her creators. They wish to look to the future and not linger in a prison of the past.
The Asians set in motion 7 rejoinings before we came to oppose them. How many more worlds would have been lost had we not placed our faith in her? How many more souls living in the present would have been snuffed out for the sake of those long dead?
And after the cinematic, I will have to stop, unfortunately.
Well, in That's light bad. Of recent events, I see no reason to doubt your words. And even if Heidelin is not a god in truth, if Minfilia believed that we should trust in her plans, then I choose to do just that. Which brings me to a rather important question. Let's suppose we try but fail to stop this second coming of the final days. Should the source fall, what will become of the other worlds?
That's a good question. The nomenclature is more fitting than you know. They just die, I'm guessing. Bring ruin to the source and its reflections will share in its fate. Oh, that's not good. That cannot possibly be good. It is ready. Wait, that was good? This way, if you would be so kind. Okay. How much more cinematic is there? Oh no. I guess it's long-ish. A beautiful sight, is it not?
Yes, but what is it?
Heidelin knew better than any that her power was not absolute. Indeed, she has ever struggled to hold Zodiac and his faithful at bay. She feared the worst and so made preparations. In the event of his demise, there would be a contingency. The moon is no more than a prison. It is a festival capable of holding, of bearing the people of Aetheris to safe harbor. Oh, it is more than a prison, I mean. Damn. I misread that. So it's an ark. The moon itself is an ark. You need not go far to find its pilots. In fact, I should be happy to take you to them. Okay. I assumed the ark on the menu was, especially with Charlian being hella secretive, was them being like, we're going to ark ourselves to the moon so that we do not die, Lamel. I did not expect the moon itself. I can fulfill my final duty as a watcher in the dark. Ah, that explains the hood. You're a bit tall to be a watcher in the dark, my man. Usually a bit short, ain't they? Dark Angels jokes, yeah. Terrible Dark Angels jokes, but still. In a shadow's wake. Yay! Better weapon that I can actually crack for war. The very last thing I do will be to crack the coffer. Oh, well. Fair reference to FF4, where the moon brought a race to the world that it takes place on. Nice. That's one of the things I find interesting about this game, is learning all of these little bits and pieces about, like, previous FF games. Oh, the Bismuth Axe looks just like the fucking Skaven Axe, which is a look I'm not hugely a fan of. There you go. Well, yes. Like I said, I can't afford to play more right now. I ain't got time for that. Feels very bad. So I will have to stop. So 75 the storyline is taken from previous Final Fantasies in one way or another. Yeah, pretty much. Well, friends. It sucks, but I gotta stop. It feels bad. But I'll see you all next time. Hopefully, maybe even tomorrow. That is not a guarantee. Less so than last night where I was attempting to, but then couldn't. But the point is, there might be something on, there might not be. We'll see. Hopefully I get to stream instead, because I'm gonna keep going. Holy shit, this game's so good. But yeah, I will see you all next time. And thank you, Alan, for helping with the trial and everything. That was good. That was fun. Yeah. I'll see you all next time, I suppose. Bye.